Alright, and we are back, and we will be bringing you the top 4 game between Nelsom
and Weiwen.
And Weiwen.
Yes. Using very, very interesting teams.
To the dismay of creative team builders the world over, we will be spectating a big stakes mirror match.
Yes. So, big stakes versus big stakes. Yeah.
Whether or not both players have decided to make tiny changes to the movesets, particularly the smear girl.
Yep.
Remains to be seen, as well as what Groudon sets both are running.
Yeah. But more or less, yeah. More or less to be quite equal among both of them. So maybe a lot of speed ties, perhaps?
Yep, speed ties, sleep turns. Geomancy, damage rolls, yeah.
Yeah, you know, the usual. That is the defining battle of VGC16.
Definitely has been so far. Alright, both players are ready and we'll be moving shortly into the battle. As we did say before, we do see a big six mirror, so although the positions are arranged differently, it is looking at the Xerneas, Smeargle, Talonflame, Kangaskhan, Salamence, and Groudon.
Yeah, I think both teams need no explanation or elaboration here. Big six versus big six, the scariest, most intimidating team out here because, you know, mainly because of Smeargle Dark Void. But I guess Weiwen is actually carrying the Scarf Smeargle with Dark Void, so that might
actually both players go straight up for their Geomancy setup.
Yeah.
If we do see a Smeargle Xerneas into a Smeargle Xerneas, Weiwen definitely has the advantage there.
Yes, because
he will get the Scarf Dark Void off before.
But I think both players are probably going to lead Kanga and Xerneas, and they will fake out each other.
So of course, if Nelsom does expect the Scarf Smeargle to come out, he has the option, of course, of bringing out his Talonflame to quickly pick up the Smeargle with Braveburn. Though in return, he has to watch out for Weiwen going for a Salamence lead. Since Intimidate will allow Smeargle to survive one Brave Bird. Right, both players are ready and we will be moving into our game one of this very exciting Big Six Mirror match. Alright, so Nelsom. Is this Nelsom? No, this is Weiwen. Weiwen comes out with the Kangaskhan and Xerneas, and Nelsom leaves with the Smeargle Xerneas.
Also known as the Monkey Lead.
Alright, so potentially, we do see Nelsom having the faster Xerneas here, since Fairy Aura did proc first. And
I think Kangaskhan wouldn't want to take any chances and just go for the fake out onto the Smeargle to prevent any Dark Voids coming out.
Right, he does chance the Spiky Shield, of course.
Yes, of course.
It's definitely worth the risk.
Yeah.
Since Dark Void going off would definitely potentially just end the game.
Yeah, more or less.
And both Xerneas, well, both Xerneas only have one thing in mind, right?
Yeah, Geomancy.
So it remains to be seen how the speeds will come into play, since we did see Nelsom's Fairy Aura go off first, but again, that could have been a speed die.
Indeed.
Of course, one player could be playing Timid and the other player could be playing Modest. So I think we're looking at Weiwen's screen right now and Xerneas does not carry much HP investment at all.
So probably both Timid.
So definitely going for the attack here. But would he be trying to deny the Geomancy or trying to stop the Smeargle from coming up with any shenanigans? Oh, but no fake out coming out, as Smeargle does get a fake out off onto the Xerneas. As Xerneas will get the Geomancy off. As Kangaskhan, probably going for double edge here. Though whether or not it's going for to weaken the Xerneas or to kill the Smeargle remains to be seen.
Yes.
So Nelsom not going for the fake out onto the Kangaskhan. Since he recognized that Weiwen could easily have stayed in non-mega form with inner focus. As yes, Kangaskhan goes for double edge. Will he be finishing off the Smeargle? He goes for the Smeargle and will get that.
But then now, Xerneas is at plus 2 with Geomancy.
And at full health to boot.
Yes, at full health to boot.
And Kangaskhan, after the recoil, is pretty much in danger of getting KO'd by the Dazzling Gleam.
Yeah.
As Nelsom will be able to bring out his own Kangaskhan, or even his Salamence, as it presumes. Yep, it is the Salamence. And he might be in a position here to just double edge the Xerneas and Dazzling Gleam and pick up 2 KOs.
Yeah.
And even the Kangaskhan hangs on. At minus 1, he's not of a threat to KO either the Xerneas or the Salamence. In fact, at this point, he might not even be doing half to the Xerneas. So Weiwen in a very difficult position here, as Nelsom has gotten the Geomancy off, and will just be looking to carry the momentum all the way from here.
So probably the play is going to go Dazzling Gleam and Double H.
Right,
into either,
Salamence go for the Mega Evolution.
Yeah, Nelsom doesn't really need to think about what Pokemon to target here because, you know, with a plus 2 Xerneas on the field, more or less the game is...
Right, Xerneas chooses to protect. So, Weiwen calling the play and hoping to hang on. Oh, actually goes for Double Edge and Moonblast, so Double Edge into the Kangaskhan. will be enough to KO with the damage from the previous recoil, and Salamence not having been intimidated. So Weiwen going for a defensive play and pretty much getting punished for it. As Nelson recognizing that Double Edge was enough to KO the Kangaskhan, and Moonblast would have been enough to KO the Xerneas as well.
Yes.
So instead of going for the spread attack, went for the single targets and same result, really.
And now with Weiwen Xerneas having protected, probably going to eat plus two Moonblast from...
Alright, so Weiwen brings out the Smeargle, which we do know is Scarf. Unfortunately for the Smeargle, the Xerneas has already Geomancy.
Yes.
So a Dazzling Gleam will send Smeargle back to the depths of where he emerged. And Weiwen, see, not much he can do in this position. Right, Dazzling Gleam come out and will easily pick off the Smeargle, barring some ridiculous special defense investment, which he does not carry.
And Double is probably going to... It's definitely going to come out. Oh, Hyper Voice, actually.
Hyper Voice will be enough.
It will be enough.
KO the Xerneas. As Weiwen is brought down to his last Pokemon. Probably the Groudon. Yep, it is the Groudon. Again, really nothing you can do here. Xerneas and Salamence able to go for Hyper Voice Moonblast to finish off this game. And of course, the Xerneas is still at full HP.
And Groudon not really having much special defense, will probably eat these two attacks, won't be able to take these two attacks very well. Probably going to go down to both of them.
Yeah, we were just going to forfeit immediately. So very commanding victory, which as really, the game was won on turn one, as many of these games are, won and lost.
Yeah,
also got the Geomancy off, took Nelly Dribble that lost a Smeargle, which really wasn't doing that much for in that position.
So against Big Six teams, once the Xerneas gets up a Geomancy, more or less his game from there.
Weiwen made a really strange decision to put Smeargle at the back. A Scarf Smeargle in particular, against a Big Six Mirror, you would think you have to bring it out as soon as possible because once Xerneas Geomancy goes up, your Smeargle is total dead weight.
So I think in game 2 he better bring the... probably will lead a Talon Smeargle to at least more or less guarantee a Dark Void against Nelson's team.
He has options of course, so it's up to him. So if he calls another Smeargle Xerneas lead, and he can always go with his own Smeargle Xerneas.
Yeah.
To get his own Dark Void off, because Nelson can only fake out one. If he fakes out the Xerneas, Smeargle Dark Void is both of his Pokemon. If he fakes out the Smeargle, then Xerneas gets the Geomancy. But then in the case they match Geomancies.
So it's a choice of really choosing your poison actually in this Big Six matchup.
Weiwen really has to choose whether or not he wants to bring Smeargle at all. And if he does bring Smeargle, I think he really has to lead it.
Yeah. He has to lead it, and he needs a supporting Pokemon like, you know, Talonflame to quick guard and just get the Dark Void out as soon as possible.
Right. Weiwen might be better off just rolling the dice on Dark Void here because he's just not having the appropriate setup so far. Right, so we're moving on to game 2. Nelson going with the standard Smeargle Xerneas lead and just carrying the momentum all the way. But no changes from Weiwen. Weiwen goes for Kanga Smeargle this time around. So the Scarf Smeargle protected by the fake out from Kangaskhan. Though Nelson makes the adjustment and goes for Salamence and Xerneas. So intimidate onto the Kangaskhan is going to go a long way. But he has no way to stop the Dark Void going.
Yeah, Dark Void is more or less going to come out. And it just depends whether it misses, hits or misses.
In fact, Weiwen is actually free. If he's willing to trust in the accuracy of Dark Void here, Weiwen is actually free to get a switch to whatever he wants into a better position and the Dark Void off as well. Potentially into his own Xerneas, in fact.
So the only way that Nelson can prevent Dark Void going up is protecting.
Yep. And protecting really doesn't further his position at all.
Yeah.
Since Smeargle will still be faster next turn regardless. In fact, Nelson might want to switch Salamence out because if he's not going to be doing much on the field, he might want to preserve the Intimidate for future turns.
Yeah.
Though again, if he just chooses to switch, the problem there is that whoever switches in will be forced to not take a turn of sleep.
Oh, but Nelson actually goes for the...
Yeah, I think Nelson wants to burn his sleep turns. Uh-huh. Recognizing that Kangaskhan at -1 is not much of a threat at all.
Weiwen actually choosing to let his Kangaskhan stay in.
I think Weiwen not trusting the accuracy of Dark Void here. Alright, so protect from the Salamence. So Dark Void at most will be landing on the Xerneas. Oh, but double protect coming out.
But Dark Void is going to go out anyway on the next turn.
And going for the fake out there, somewhat dubious play.
Perhaps Weiwen should actually take this opportunity to switch out and bring in his Xerneas. Then he could actually get off Geomancy against Nelson.
Yes, I think that window definitely was there last turn, definitely. since the thing, nothing has changed on the field. Just that both of the Pokemon have burned their protects. So at the same time, Weyvern still has no way to generate offense with the minus one Kangaskhan unless he carries Power Up Punch.
So play here will actually to switch out Kangaskhan, bring in his Xerneas and fire off another Dark Void and hope that hits.
Yes. Or if he does carry Power Up Punch, now will be the turn to Power Up Punch. But in fact, no. So I think it's safe to assume he does not carry Power Up Punch.
And
then we just see the Xerneas.
Yep.
So making the turn, making the switch possibly a turn too late, as Dark Void will go off and will get at least one of his targets asleep. Lands on the Xerneas. Will he get the Salamence? He gets the Salamence as well.
Uh-huh.
And both of Nelsom's Pokemon will take their first turns of sleep.
So now Weyvern, all he has to do is to set up Geomancy. And Nelsom, not too sure whether he's going to burn the sleep or risk it and just switch in, but probably not the best decision also because Smeargle can just stay in and fire off another Dark Void.
Weyvern also has to decide whether he wants to keep Smeargle in or not.
Yeah. But Smeargle probably has done his job. Actually, making both of Nelson's leads asleep. Now he's free to set up Geomancy, provided that Nelsom doesn't...
But Weyvern does shoot Smeargle out, preserving the threat of Dark Void for a future turn. To bring in Kangaskhan, to refresh his fake out.
Yes. And without the intimidation.
Salamence does not wake up after one turn. Mm-hmm. And we do see Weyvern get the Geomancy off, and Nelsom will be praying to get his Geomancy off as well, through the sleep.
So it remains to be seen whether Nelsom's Xerneas picks up this turn and gets the Geomancy.
Alright, so Geomancy does go off here, and Nelsom's Xerneas.
Okay. This is more or less game for Weyvern actually, because he has a plus 2 Xerneas on the field and fake out, yes.
Yeah. Xerneas will go down to a Dazzling Gleam, and the Xerneas is locked down by the Kangaskhan fake out.
So, play here will just to be fake out the Xerneas and just go for Dazzling Gleam.
So once again, we see one player getting Smeargle and Xerneas onto the field at the same time, and that same player looks to carry the momentum all the way to a win.
Yep.
Though Weyvern possibly in a better position than Nelsom was previously, because now he has Kangaskhan on the field with a fresh fake out, ready to go.
And a plus 2 Xerneas to boot.
Right, so Xerneas unable to protect.
Second turn.
Dazzling Gleam does go off.
And will KO the...
That was his third turn of speed. Yes. So Dazzling Gleam will KO and Kangaskhan will get the easy knockout with the double edge. Though, Faker might have been enough anyway.
Yeah.
And we have saved him a bit of recoil, but when you're this far ahead...
Yeah, it doesn't matter anymore.
It's just technicalities.
Unless you are really looking for a very clean 4-0 sweep with no loss of HP on your side.
Nelsom really needs to fish for Talonflame Brinkbird crits at this point. If he did bring the Talonflame, yes, he did do. Though again, Xerneas can just protect.
But it doesn't really matter actually, he just has to fire off another Dazzling Gleam.
Yep. Definitely, even with critical hit, Reaper is not going to do enough to the Xerneas. So Xerneas can afford to take a hit and fire off whatever it wants. Dazzling Gleam, possibly even Moonblast.
So
Nelsom does resist, have two fairy resists on the field right now, but Talonflame, not the bulkiest of resists.
And with a plus 2 Moonblast or Dazzling Gleam, both of them will take a sizable amount of damage.
Talonflame might just be knocked out right off. So the other option for Nelsom there is to sacrifice his Talonflame for the Tailwind, which he does do. So Tailwind goes off, but at the same time, Weyvern did not protect his Xerneas. So he's getting the attacks off this turn, and that could be game right here. Dazzling Gleam will go off, and will take Talonflame to below half. And a lot of damage to the Groudon as well, which is probably a jolly max speed Groudon. Double Edge will pick up the Talonflame, and it will be Groudon against the world.
Yeah.
Needs a critical hit on the Precipice Blades here. Or even an Eruption if he carries it.
Mm-hmm.
Goes for Precipice Blades, he does land. Will he get a crit on either of Weyvern's Pokemon? Nope, no crits here. But with Tailwind going up, it's a quite an interesting position here because we're not entirely sure how fast Weyvern's Xerneas is, so of course if it is timid max speed, then this game is over. Since
probably
a combination of Sucker Punch and Blast will finish off the Groudon.
It's probably timid max speed.
Xerneas is timid max speed. Moonblast will go off and bring us to a game 3. A total reversal
of game 1 actually.
A very similar situation, but unfortunately for Nelsom, he was on the receiving end of it this time.
So we'll be proceeding on to a game 3.
Certainly. Yeah. No worries about timer running out in a matchup like this.
Yeah. Very clean 4-0 sweep by Weiwen there.
Weiwen, as we did discuss, Weiwen really needed to leverage that Scarf Smegle.
Yeah.
And he did that perfectly.
So now Nelsom has to really prevent that Scarf Smegle from firing off Dark Void.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the thing is, Weiwen has shown an inclination to bring Kangaskhan to this matchup. Mm-hmm. And without the Sentiments, without the Intimidate, it means the Talon Flame is pretty free to fire off Brave Bird into the Smeargle. Whereas with Sentiments, the threat of Intimidate, Talon Flame can't freely Brave Bird. Because the Brave Bird into Smeargle and it survives and Dark Void goes off, that could be the game right there. But without the threat of Sentiments, Nelsom has to be thinking very hard about leading with the Talon Flame. Mm-hmm. Since even if the matchup isn't ideal, he can at least get the Tailwind off faster to keep the Xerneas more in check. Because again, if you do see a Smeargle Xerneas mirror, Weiwen is going to come out on top because of the scarf.
Actually,
Nelsom magically pulls out Magic Coat or Crafty Shield all of a sudden. Though since he carries Fake Out, it's very unlikely he carries either of those moves. Weiwen going for the defensive lead of the Talonflame Quick Guard protecting the scarf Smeargle as Nelsom goes for the Kangaskhan and Xerneas.
Yeah, so more or less, Dark Void is going to come out here. The play here for Weiwen is just the Quick Guard and fire off Dark Void.
Yep, Quick Guard to protect the Smeargle from the Fake Out, and Dark Void will go off.
So Nelsom really has to pray that Dark Void misses.
But the other option for Nelsom here, of course, is to not go for a Fake Out.
Yeah.
Because if he goes for normal attack, he'll be able to take one turn of sleep with his Kangaskhan. Mm-hmm. So he increases the odds of either of the Pokemon waking up the next turn and doing damage to the Xerneas. Mm-hmm. Oh, in fact, the Xerneas is not on the field right now. So the problem with Weiwen here is that while he has the Surefire Dark Void, he doesn't have that much of a way to generate offense beyond Talon Flame, which could be a problem further down the line.
Yeah.
If Nelsom gets any one-turn wake-ups, so if Dark Void misses.
Yeah, so Weiwen really needs to land that Dark Void and pray for a 3-turn sleep from Nelsom.
Because he needs time to shuffle his Pokemon around to get his own Xerneas onto the field.
And Geomancy.
The moment Nelsom wakes up and gets his Geomancy off,
the
tables could really turn. Mm-hmm. Right, Weiwen locked in his moves really quickly. Presumably, it is a Quick Guard Dark Void.
Yeah.
So the question is Nelsom, whether Nelsom goes for the Fake Out anyway, which he could choose to go, or he could choose to call the Quick Guard and go for a normal attack to a turn of sleep.
And pray that the Dark Void misses.
No, but no Quick Guard coming out as Tailwind comes off for Weiwen, and no Fake Out coming out in fact. So Dark Void will go off onto the Kangaskhan and to the Xerneas. Are we going to see a miss? Oh, we do see a miss onto the Xerneas.
Xerneas is probably going to go for...
Since Xerneas is going for Geomancy.
Oh, okay.
But since Talonflame did go for Tailwind, Smeargle is free to Dark Void one more time.
Yes, yes. So Smeargle is still the fastest thing on the field right now because he's having a choice scarf.
But now he has to worry about Kangaskhan getting one turn of sleep.
Yeah. Weiwen really needs to play a more aggressive, more risky play actually. Bring his Xerneas, fire off another Dark Void and get his Geomancy up. Because now...
Yeah, now he has really has to make a decision. Whether he wants to keep, Talonflame in and get some cheap damage off, or threaten his own sweep with his Xerneas. Whereas Nelsom is actually... But the problem with that is that if that Weiwen goes for a switch here, the danger here is that Nelsom could just protect his Xerneas from the Dark Void and fish for a wake up with his Kangaskhan. Mm-hmm. Weiwen really has locked in his moves, so fairly confident about his game plan from here. Since he actually just goes for the stay in. As Brave Bird will go off, no protect from Nelsom, Brave Bird into the Xerneas.
Into the Xerneas.
No, into the Kangaskhan, in fact. Doing a huge amount of damage.
Yeah.
With the Life Orb, of course, as Xerneas will get hit by the Dark Void. So Xerneas will take his first turn of sleep. And Nelsom will be hoping for Kangaskhan to wake up. Alright, so Xerneas will take his first turn of sleep, and Kangaskhan will not wake up after one turn.
So I think Weiwen really needs to play risky here, bring in his Xerneas and just set up Geomancy.
Yeah.
And just keep firing off Dark Voice, praying that both of them don't wake up.
But Weiwen has shown an inclination to get his Smeargle out whenever he can, so...
Yeah.
The other choice, of course, is to switch Smeargle out, bring forward to finish off the Kangaskhan, and get Xerneas in. But then he runs the risk of Kangaskhan coming in for Nelsom. Talonflame coming in from Nelsom. And of course, the chance of Xerneas waking up.
And firing off a plus 2 Dazzling Gleam or Moogas.
Right. Weiwen does make the switch again, taking out the Scarf Smeargle for
and
the
Groudon.
So not going, trying to go for the Geomancy. I think we are going to see the Bravehead once again mm-hmm. to finish off the Kangaskhan. Oh, but Nelson actually choosing to switch out his Kangaskhan, not wanting to take the Bravebird.
And for his own Groudon, yeah.
Instead letting Groudon take the hit, which is a questionable decision. Mm-hmm. But I suppose now Kangaskhan does have a fresh fake out and the chance to wake up during that fake out. So a calculated risk for Nelson here. And of course, Xerneas waking up to change everything.
Yeah. So Weyburn really has to pray that Xerneas doesn't wake up.
Bravebird into Xerneas does do more than half. Xerneas, Talon Flame is slowly bringing himself down with recoil. As Xerneas does not wake up. So Weyburn is getting the long sleeve that he needs to pull ahead in this game. He does have Groudon with Tailwind. Though you would expect Nelson to be fishing for the double protect here.
Yeah. Talon Flame just has to Bravebird into the Xerneas slot and his Groudon just has to go for Precipice Blades and more or less he will seal the game for Weyburn.
Yep, a single target Precipice Blades is gonna hurt. Since we know that Nelson is not running a bulky Groudon. No, but Nelson's Xerneas takes a full third turn of sleep, unable to protect, and will go down to the Bravebird. Oh, but Bravebird actually going into the... Oh, and Precipice Blades, is it going to land? Oh, he does have... Weyburn taking a risk there.
Yeah, that's a very big risk. Yes, yes. Actually,
now Xerneas is free to protect, and Groudon will get the KO on the Talon Flame with Rock Slide.
Yeah.
So, of course, the Rock Slide missed.
Yeah.
And luck has not been going Nelson's way so far.
Yeah, yeah. Weyburn really should have
not targeted the safe play there.
Yeah, yeah. Too risky, in fact.
A very strange play because after Bravebird kills the Xerneas, he will be getting a single target Precipice Blade on the Groudon. Even if he did not, assuming he did not protect, of course. So all of a sudden, Nelson in a much better position. Xerneas is still at +2 and the Talon Flame is at risk of being KO'd. And once the threat of priority is gone, Xerneas is going to be a lot happier. Mm-hmm. So Nelson is the one who seems to be taking his time here.
Probably the play will be just to protect the Xerneas and go for a Rock Slide.
Yes. Or even a Fire Punch, doesn't want the chance of missing.
Yeah.
Oh, but actually no! Nelson just to switch out the Groudon into the Talon Flame. And runs the risk of Weyburn actually going for the Bravebird onto the Xerneas, so...
Very questionable play from...
Weyburn goes for the Bravebird into the Talon Flame.
And takes it out.
And Xerneas will get a free attack off, but... And a single target attack for that matter onto the Groudon, if it is the Dazzling Gleam. But of course, Moonblast. Xerneas goes for the Dazzling Gleam, single target. It's not going to be enough to KO the Groudon, of course.
But I take quite a sizable amount.
Precipice Blades is going to land this time. Single target will bring down Xerneas. But with no form of speed control available for Nelson, Smeagol is going to come back and threaten with the Scarf Dark Void once again.
Yeah.
Right, so Smeagol does make his reappearance. As Kangaskhan will come in, asleep for that matter, and having only taken one turn of sleep.
Yeah.
So only a 50% chance of waking up here. And not even 50 in fact. Yeah, actually 50% chance of waking up here.
Nelson really hoping that he can wake up and fake out the Smeagol before he can fire off any more Dark Voids and then land a hit from his Groudon.
Oh, but Kangaskhan is not able to get a fake out off, and that could be game. As Weyburn goes for the Destiny Bond.
Revealing the Destiny.
Take Groudon down with it, assuming Precipice Blades, which does land on the Smeagol and the Groudon. So it's going to be a one-on-one. I believe you're going to see a Kangaskhan mirror for the last. So Weyburn will bring out his last Pokemon.
This is really the battle of speed ties here.
So Weyburn will bring in his last Pokemon, likely his own Kangaskhan, to face off against Nelson's Kangaskhan. Mm-hmm. But Weyburn will have Fake Out available, and at this point, Fake Out might be all it takes to bring down Nelson's Kangaskhan. Who may not even wake up. But actually no, it is Xerneas. So Weyburn potentially could still lose a double edge critical hit here.
Yeah.
But with Nelson's luck, he's probably not gonna wake up. Oh, he does wake up. He does go for double edge. Is he gonna get a critical hit? Double edge last hit.
He got a crit! Oh!
And he does take out the Xerneas. Nelson will bring himself down. And Nelson will win the 0-0 game 3.
Very exciting match here.
The one roll he needed.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
After pretty much 3-2 yes. games of really bad luck, and he got that one roll. Takes the 0-0, and will be advancing to the final against Brian Seoul. So Nelsom played with his outs, of course.
Yes, of course.
He just needed to double.
Really mattered, yes.
And we want to be really regretting not bringing Kangaskhan in that last slot. Since if Kangaskhan had been there, fake out and
yes.
win the
wins. Yeah.
So we weren't definitely leveraging his Scarf's Miracle, but at the end, he might have been better off going for the down boy.
Yeah.
Instead of the Destiny Bond, since he set up what looked like a favorable endgame, mm-hmm. which really all he could lose to was a crit.
Yeah,
but actually, Nelsom got the crit.
Yeah, what are the chances? But yeah, that's VGC16 for you.
So Weaver chose to set up the endgame, and Nelsom saw his one out, and he took it, getting the critical hit, and will be advancing to the final against Brian Seoul. So congratulations, Nelsom, and we will be moving very shortly into the final. So stay tuned.
Any interview?
Yeah, done already.